In The Last of Us Part 2 and the Left Behind DLC, as well as in the HBO TV show and the comic series American Dreams, Ellie is often seen with a Walkman. Whether you're looking to add this cassette player to your collection, enhance your Ellie cosplay, or simply own the exact model she uses, this is the guide that can save you a little money, since fully functioning units can cost $400 or more. If you'd like to jump straight into the repair process, skip to this timestamp to bypass this introduction. For those who want some context, let's continue. Welcome to our video guide on repairing a vintage Sony Walkman WM-1. Before we dive in, let's talk about finding one of these iconic devices. You'll find Sony Walkman WM-1s on eBay or other platforms, but be prepared, fully working units can cost around $400 or more. However, if you're up for a challenge, you can often find defective ones for about $70. That's what inspired this repair guide. If you're on the hunt for one, be patient. New listings appear every few weeks. Just be careful not to confuse the WM-1 with similar-looking models like the WM-F1 or WM-4. Many units you'll find might have issues. Common descriptions include plays fine, FFREW do not work, or doesn't play when it only works with an external power supply. These are great starting points for repair. In this guide, we'll address two common problems. 1. Corrosion of the battery contacts, which often causes the unit to only work with an external power supply. 2. Issues with FFREW functionality, usually due to a combination of a broken part and a defective belt. For the broken part, we'll be using a 3D printed replacement. You can find the file on Thingiverse if you have 3D printing capabilities, or order one from Shapeways for about $15. The replacement belt costs around $7. Screws. There are two on the back, two on the bottom, and two inside the cassette compartment. Keep these screws safe as we'll need them later. Step 2, detach the volume adjuster. Use pointed tweezers to turn the inner part counterclockwise. Then, loosen the outer part with a flathead screwdriver. Be gentle to avoid damaging the components. Step 3, remove the back plate. Carefully lift it off to reveal the internal components. Step 4. You'll see some tapes holding wires to the circuit board. Carefully remove these tapes. We recommend cutting new pieces for reassembly later. Step 5. Carefully remove the housing. This step requires extra caution. Gently remove the front part of the enclosure, starting from where the motor is located. Be extremely careful with the cables, they're delicate and can easily be damaged. If you're not experienced with soldering, avoid pulling or stressing any connected cables. Step 6. Remove battery contacts corrosion. If your unit has corroded battery contacts, now's the time to clean them. Use a grinding accessory or sandpaper, and consider applying dielectric grease to preserve them. Step 7. Carefully detach the circuit board. First, loosen the cables, then remove the single screw holding it in place. Gently remove it from the plastic holding clip and set it aside. Step 8. Detach the eject mechanism. Now for a tricky part, removing the eject mechanism. Be very careful not to lose the small spring, it tends to hop away and can be hard to find and replace. Remove the screw and the screw washer carefully. Step 9. Address first replacement part. Now we'll replace the part causing fast forward rewind issues. You'll see a small yellow part that needs replacing. Instead of removing more attached parts, we'll carefully separate it by pushing the holding part up and right, while pushing the part we're removing down and left. Be extremely careful not to bend the attached part too much, there's no replacement for that. Once removed, you'll see a metal spring part underneath. Remove this too, as we'll need to transfer it to the new part. The replacement part might need some modification. Use a drill to widen the center hole, starting with smaller bits and working up to 2 millimeters. Once ready, carefully place the metal spring into the new part, ensuring it's secure. When reinserting, make sure the metal spring sits between the two plastic holders. Step 10. Reassemble the eject mechanism. First, place the distance ring, then the play mechanism. Insert the screw socket, followed by the eject mechanism itself. Make sure it sits correctly as shown in the reference images. Reinsert and tighten the holding screw. Finally, put the screw washer back on, pressing it down slightly so it sits tight. Step 11, address second replacement part. Now we'll replace the belt. Loosen the two screws shown in the images. Gently shift the black control panel to one side and remove the plate covering the belt. There's a screw attached to a white cable. The screw holder here is wobbly, so hold it with tweezers while unscrewing. Now you can replace the old belt with a new one. Step 12, continue reassembling. Reinsert the cables into the designated section of the plate. There's a clear indent for this. Put the plate back in place. Reinsert and tighten the screws securing the white cable, followed by the other two screws. Position the screw holder so it doesn't touch the belt. Finally, set the board in the clip and put in the holding screw. Step 13, reattach the housing. It's time to put the front part of the enclosure back on. Pay special attention to the red battery indicator, make sure it sits in the right place. A poorly seated indicator is often a sign of a previously opened unit. Step 14, reattach the wires with electric tape. Now we'll secure the cables with tape again. Use the new pieces of electrical tape we prepared earlier to hold the wires in place on the circuit board. Step 15, screw the housing back together. Put the back plate on and reinsert all six enclosure screws. Make sure they're tight but don't over-tighten, as this could damage the plastic. Step 16, screw the volume adjustment parts back in. Reattach the volume adjustment parts. Step 17, test the Walkman. Finally, we're ready to test. Insert a tape and check all functions: play, fast forward, rewind, and the volume control.
25 seconds. 15 seconds, guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9, ignition sequence start. Five, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff, we have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour.
Thank you so much for watching. To support this small growing channel, you can click the like button, subscribe, or share. We'll be sure to tell our cats about your support too. They get extra excited when we receive likes. And if you have any questions, recommendations, or tutorial suggestions, drop them below. We're all ears. Have a great day, and until next time.